Hello and welcome to the fifth lecture of Life Processes in Living Organisms Part 2. In this lecture, we are going to study about pollination, fertilization, double fertilization and seed germination. Let us see.
See this diagram. This is of gynoecium. See. This is a basal portion. It is of ovary. This is elongated portion, it is of style, and the tip of the style, it is called the stigma. These are the three main parts of a gynoecium or a carpel. If many carpels are there, they unite together to form a gynoecium. If single carpel is there, then also we find these parts in it. Up till we discuss about the parts of flower, the reproductive organs present in the flower. Now, we will discuss about the pollination. Pollination means the transfer of pollen grains from anthers to the stigma of gynoecium. This process is called pollination. We know that at the tip of androecium, the anthers are there, and inside the anthers, the small pollen grains are there. These pollen grains, they transfer from anthers to the stigma of the gynoecium. This process of actual transfer of pollen grains from anthers to the stigma, this is called pollination. This transfer of pollen grains from anthers to stigma, it takes place with the help of variety of agents. These agents, they may be biotic one or they may be abiotic one. In the biotic, the insects and other animals, they are responsible for the transfer of pollen grains from anthers to the stigma. And in case of abiotic factors or the agent, that may be the wind or the water. Because of wind current, the pollen grains, they transfer from anthers to the stigma. These pollen grains are very minute and lightweight particles, so they carry with the wind. Sometime because of the rainwater, these pollen grains, they transfer from anthers to the stigma of the gynoecium. So, this process of pollination, it takes place with the insects, animals or the abiotic factor like wind and water. These are the responsible for this transferring of pollen grains. This process is called pollination. We can also define this pollination like this. The process of transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma, it is called pollination. Then this pollination, it may be of two type. One is a self-pollination and other is a cross-pollination. What happens in the self-pollination? If the transfer of the pollen grain that occurs in the same flower or the another flower of the same plant. It means that suppose the pollen grains that are transferred from one flower to the other flower that are present on the same plant, or it may be from the androecium or the anthers of a flower and the gynoecium is also present in that flower. Means in case of bisexual flower, it may possible the transfer of pollen grain from the same flower. Means the transfer of pollen grains occurs in the same flower. Means from anther of the flower to the gynoecium of the same flower. Or the gynoecium present in the another flower present on the same plant. This is called self-pollination. And cross-pollination means the pollen grain, if transfer from one flower to the flower of another plant of the same species. Different trees or the plants are there. So, but these plants should be of same species. The pollen grain transfer from one flower to the flower that present on another plant of the same species. This is called cross pollination, and this occur because of the agent which are we discussed in the earlier slide, that is maybe wind, water or the animals. This pollination takes place. It is a very very important for the next process, and that is the fertilization. See this fertilization, how, what happens after the transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma. In this diagram, see once again, this is a basal solen portion. It is of gynoecium, basal solen portion of gynoecium. It is called ovary. This elongated portion, it is called style, and this is the stigma. At the tip of style, the stigma is present. This stigma, it is sticky in nature. So during pollination, once the pollen grain that form on the stigma of the gynoecium, it is a sticky. So these pollen grains, they remain adhere on the stigma. They stick to the stigma. It is a moist one, so that these pollen grains start to germinate there. When they fall on the sticky and moist stigma, the pollen grains start to germinate there, and a pollen tube that is produced from the pollen grain. This long pollen tube, it bears two male gametes. That means one pollen grain, it gives rise two male gametes. So once it germinate, the pollen tube produced, and in that pollen tube two male gametes are there. They also transfer with this pollen tube towards the ovary. One pollen grain, it gives rise two male gametes. So pollen tube, it reaches up to the embryo sac. This is the ovary, and inside that this embryo sac is there. This pollen tube, it reaches up to the embryo sac along with the male gamete. The tip of pollen tube, it burst, and two male gametes, these are released in the embryo sac. Once this pollen tube reaches to the embryo sac, the tip get burst, and that male gamete that released into the ovary, or that are released into the embryo sac. One male gamete, it unite with the egg cell to form the zygote. Inside the ovary, the female gametes are there, that is the egg cells are there. So out of two male gamete, one male gamete, it fuses with egg cell, and it gives rise the zygote. This process is called fertilization. Remember that fertilization means the male gamete unite with the egg cell to form the zygote. This is called the fertilization. Then second male gamete, it unite with the two polar nuclei which are present in the embryo sac. Along with the egg cell, the polar nuclei are there. So the second male gamete, it fuses with the polar nuclei, and it gives rise the endosperm. Endosperm, it is a nutritive tissue. It provides the nourishment to the developing zygote. So as two nuclei, they participate in this process. That means one fuses with one male gamete, that is egg cell, and second time the second male gamete fuses with the polar nuclei. Since two times fusion is there, so this process is called double fertilization. Two times fusion, two times fertilization occurs, hence it is called double fertilization. We can understand this double fertilization in the video clearly. I provide the link in the description box. Go to the description box and you may observe the process of double fertilization in angiosperms very clearly.
In flowering plants, double fertilization involves the fusion of two sperm cell nuclei of the male gametophyte with two cell nuclei of the female gametophyte. The tube cell of the pollen grain elongates to form a pollen tube. The tube nucleus leads the way through the tissue of the style toward the female gametophyte. The two sperm cells travel through the pollen tube and enter the ovule. One sperm fuses with the haploid egg cell to form the zygote. The other sperm unites with the diploid central cell to form a triploid cell that will develop into endosperm.
See once again, after the pollen grains that land on the stigma, they germinate there. This is a summary. The pollen tube grows out from a pollen grain and reaches up to the ovary through the style. Each pollen tube, it contains two male gametes and one release and release them near the egg cell. One male gamete fuses with egg cell to form zygote. Second male gamete fuses with secondary nucleus in the embryo sac, or that is also called polar nucleus, and they form the endosperm. This is called double fertilization. The zygote, it gives rise embryo, and endosperm, it gives rise the nutritive tissue. So this is the process of fertilization. Then what happens after the fertilization? Once fertilization is there, there is a formation of zygote. That zygote divides and redivides many times and gives rise the seed. And we know that once the seed formation is there, the seed get germinate. The process of development of seedlings is there, and that seedlings gives rise the new plant body under appropriate condition. This process is called germination. See, seed germinate in appropriate condition and gives rise the new plant body. This is called germination. To understand the germination, see the video.
Germination. The journey of a seed to a seedling passes through many stages of growth. In the early stages, when a seed is placed in moist soil, it absorbs the water around it. The water then reaches the beginning of the baby plant or the embryo within the seed. This makes the embryo grow and increase in size. Eventually, the embryo breaks open the seed coat and comes out of the seed. The root comes out first and grows into the soil. This fixes the baby plant to the soil and helps the root absorb water and nutrients from the soil. Then the shoot comes out of the seed and starts to grow towards the sun. The first pair of leaves that come out of the seed with the shoot are called cotyledons. The root grows longer. The shoot becomes green and sprouts more leaves. This is a young plant and is called a seedling or sapling. For all these stages of germination, essential conditions or factors are required.
If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe it and press the bell icon to get the notifications of next video. Thank you.